Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Isabella and Lewis! Yeah! That was pretty incredible, right? It's going to be an incredible event, so make sure you do get your tickets. You can find them, of course, through the British Gymnastics website. But we are just minutes away, ladies and gentlemen, from the main event. Ladies and gentlemen, day three of the British Championships. Some very special people we couldn't do it without, though. Would you put your hands together and welcome in your judges?
So here we go, the pre-event show has now reached its conclusion. The judges are being welcomed to the floor. In just a few minutes, we'll be getting our first competitors out to start these junior and senior women's apparatus finals and men's masters finals, as well as our disability gymnastics competitors. The women are going to be starting off their competition on the vault, whilst the men take to the floor.
Team one, this side, team two. You know what to do, all right? So on this side, make some noise.
So you can see that John's going to be working the crowd up once again. We've had the noiseometer for the last couple of days. And of course, we can't start the competition until the crowd are sufficiently fired up. So John's just giving them a real wind up now. and you can really hear the noise levels here in the Echo Arena are rising up today. We've had a fantastic crowd here over the course of the weekend. Yesterday we had the highest ever attendance at a British Championships event, which was truly fantastic. Great not only for the atmosphere in the arena, but also fantastic experience for the gymnasts. And there you go, the flame cannons have been set off. We are clear to start this fantastic final day of the 2015 British Gymnastics Championship. So our senior women are going to be starting off their competition on the vault. And we get to see the return of Lisa Mason, one of the gymnasts who started in the second subdivision yesterday. She'll be looking to take home some medals today. Managed to play 7th in the all round, but qualified through to the vault, beam and floor final. And a big roar for Claudia Fragapani, of course had a fantastic 2014, well liked by this crowd. And she'll be hoping to take home a few more medals today, maybe to build on that silver that she won in the all round and take home a few golds. We've got a fantastic masters lineup here on the floor. It's a nice mixture of our under 18 and senior gymnasts. We'll be sure to catch up with Christian Thomas, who put in a fantastic routine yesterday. And of course we get that head-to-head battle between our senior and under 18 gymnast. Gianni Regini Moran is certainly going to be looking to make an impression on the competition here today. A fantastic opportunity for him to face off against Britain's best senior gymnast. Welcoming into the arena now our disability gymnasts, who are going to be starting off their competition on the pommel horse. Whilst our senior women start over on the vault, our junior girls are going to be taking to the bars. Our top qualifier here was Georgia May Fenton from East London. Her total of 13.75 in qualifications is going to be a tough one to beat, but she's going to have a big challenge from Catherine Lyons from Europa. She didn't put all of her new upgrades into her bar routine, so we'll be keeping an eye out to see if she puts that full difficulty back in today. They're slowly putting the lights back up in the arena. Sometimes it takes a little bit of a while for the lights just to warm up again. They do look like they're in relative darkness at the moment, but I'm sure it'll be brighter in a few moments' time. Our gymnasts have been warming up outside in the back gym, but they do get the opportunity to have a touch warm-up on the apparatus here in the arena, just to get a feel for the apparatus. We have been having the gymnasts saying that some of the equipment feels a little bit different here in the arena to in the warm-up hall. So it's just a chance for them to make their final adjustments. Now in the senior vault competition, we have only got four senior gymnasts who perform two different vaults, but don't think that's going to be any less of a competition. We've got some fantastic competitors there. Junior European champion on the vault, Ellie Downey. Junior European silver medalist. Of course, former Commonwealth champion, Lisa Mason, also taking to the vault, as well as Kelly Sim from Dynamo, who showed two fantastically dynamic vaults yesterday. And of course, our reigning Commonwealth champion also, Claudia Fragapane. So really, even if there are only four gymnasts in this vault final, they've got some fantastic international calibre here. Over on the floor, the men's masters final is going to be a real treat. It's going to be an absolute head-to-head between the likes of Christian Thomas, Dan Purvis, and of course Gianni Regini Moran from the under-18 competition. So we're going to start off this competition over on the floor with Bryn Bevan from South Essex. He was our English champion just a couple of weeks ago.
Representing South Essex, Bryn Bevan.
Bryn, a fantastic all-around gymnast, but clearly... Ooh, and that was a real shame. Normally a fan of the floor apparatus, but just unable to fully rotate that double pike to Arabian. A little bit low on that landing as well. Sometimes if you just punch wrong out of the first somersault in these twisting combinations, it can be pretty difficult to generate enough rotation for the second somersault. Showing real style and confidence though as he moves through his low floor work. Ooh, crikey, and really mistimed that one. So that was going to be double twist, punch front full, but unfortunately landing on his back, the gymnasts won't be able to receive credit when they don't land feet first on the floor. And finishing up, ooh, with an attempt at the triple twist, feet not quite round. Bit of a disappointing there for the... Bit of a disappointing start there for Bryn. But I'm sure we'll be seeing him in more finals later. So we're going to be moving over to the women's vault now. And our former Commonwealth champion, Lisa Mason, is going to be the first to take to the apparatus. Lisa yesterday performed the full twist in Yurchenko, but looks like she's going for an upgrade today. Oh, crikey, and just didn't quite get the right block off the table there at all. That was a real shame. Came in very early to the table and there just really wasn't any height or block off the top of the vault at all. Unfortunately, just having to land sat down. You can see she looks a little bit disappointed with herself there, a little bit frustrated. Not an error that we've seen from Lisa before, but still one vault to go. Lisa's just composing herself now then for a second vault. Of course, she's going to have to show a different entry to the Yuchenko that she attempted in her first. And the start value now up there, it's a 5.0 difficulty vault. We'll be expecting to see a handspring pike front half. She's really got to power down the runway now. Ooh, crikey, and that was actually very close to the vault indeed. Blocked very early on the table and just not quite able to get the block off that she wanted. Not the start she'd have been hoping for, but pleased just to see she got safely to her feet on that one, because it was very close to the vault. Still waiting for the score to come in for Bryn Brevin on the floor. We have got our next competitor waiting in the corner. There we go, 11-7 the score for Bryn. After some difficulties in the middle of that routine. But here we go, ready now then for James Hall from Pegasus Gymnastics Club. Very powerful approach for that first tumble. And what a twist. That was a 2.5 twisting somersault. James, obviously a fan of these forward twisting elements, going straight back across the floor, this time with a double twist. Ooh, lovely work there. The 1.75 rollout with the 1.5 twists. The gymnasts are allowed to use one rollout skill in the course of their floor routine. Unlike the girls, the boys don't have to show a double somersault rotation if they don't choose to. You'll see many of the men here today choosing to build their difficulty with these twisting combinations. And a quiet double twist across the side of the floor. Just a slightly low chest on landing, but no big hops on landing. And pulling hard then for a triple twist to finish off his routine. Fantastically clean work there from James Hall. Back over on senior women's vault, we can now get to see Ellie Downey, of course the reigning junior European champion on this piece of apparatus. Ellie placed third in the all-around yesterday in her first ever senior British championships. And looks very composed as she goes for this first vault. Only a full twisting Yuchenko here from her today. Ellie only competed all around for the first time this year, yesterday, so I don't think we're quite seeing her at full difficulty. We're used to seeing a double twist from her in that first vault, but playing it safe today, just going for the full. As before, she's going to have to show us a different entry to the table for this second vault. Unlike Lisa though, she's still going to use her Yuchenko approach, but rather than going straight back onto the vaulting table, she'll perform a half twist before her second flight. So the first score in for Ellie, 14.15. There we go, Yuchenko half on, pike front half off. And that vault just keeps getting better and better. Plenty of potential for Ellie to upgrade in the future, but for now, that was a very clean and tidy second vault. The score in for James Hall, 14.325 on the floor, which means we're now ready for Kelvin Cham from the City of Glasgow.
Next score for the City of Glasgow, Kelvin Cham.
Kelvin finished up his all-around competition on the floor yesterday and put in a great performance here. I'm sure he'll be delighted to have made the Masters final. And starting off, double twist, punch tuck half. nice skill there. Gymnasts have to show some sideways elements or elements that turn before they go into the somersault in the men's floor routines. So nice to see something a little bit different with the kick out in midair. Simple straight back somersault in the middle of his routine. You'll often see the gymnasts do this when they're saving up their difficulty for the final pass. The gymnasts are required to show a C or a D difficulty value dismount in order to get credited their element group requirement. Kelvin there went for the 2.5 twist, which will mean he's able to build on his start value. And you can see the next competitor already up on the floor podium, clearly wanting to get all of his preparations underway. I think we're going to be taking a break from women's vault and sticking with floor. We've only got 4 competitors in the women's vault final, so we're going to be seeing a couple more floors before we come back to the girls. I think it goes to show just how difficult it is to be a vault specialist and train that second vault. Obviously all of the girls need one vault for their all-around competition, but the time it takes to be able to produce a vault of a different entry really does take a toll on their training sometimes for the other apparatus.
Next gymnast in the final for the Academy is Mimi Turner. Meanwhile, Calvin Chandler for 13.575. Next on the floor from the City of Birmingham.
Just to give you an update of how the junior girls are going over on the floor. Maisie Methuen is currently our leader with 13.25. Putting a fantastic routine over there, so she'll be hoping to hang on to a medal spot. Just as Hamish Carter from the City of Birmingham takes to the men's Masters floor final. And a lovely opening tumble, that was picture perfect. Double twist, punch, tuck, half, but chest perfectly upright on landing and very secure. Did incredibly well to correct that actually. Looked like he just underrotated it, but shifted his shoulder round, made sure of that landing. Hamish looking incredibly composed, certainly not worried by the prospect of being in this Masters final with senior competitors. A tidy double twist, no doubt saving a big final tumble for this last pass. Hamish powers hard, triple twist to finish, great job for Hamish. Certainly done himself proud here in this Masters final. Is there, so it wasn't in fact that we were taking a break, it was that we have split these rotations in half. Wasn't aware that we were doing that today, but never mind. So of course we will now have our second half of the rotation warming up. We're welcome to the vault, Claudia Fragapane, of course our current Commonwealth champion here on the vault, and also Kelly Sim from Dynamo, who's got some incredibly dynamic work to show us today. So from our two vault competitors who've been so far, we've currently got Ellie Downey from Knox in the lead with 14.175, whilst Lisa Mason from Heathrow, after those two slightly less dynamic vaults than we're used to seeing, has 12.65 and currently sits in second place.
So thanks for a very exciting competition. Now, during this split, we're going to see the first female women's disability competition over here on the beam.
Meanwhile, in the men's Masters floor final, we're yet to receive that score for Hamish Carter. Oh, in fact, there we go, just in time. 14.55 the score for him. That puts him straight up into gold medal contention. Still, some big routines to come, though, from Christian Thomas and Daniel Purvis, and, of course, Gianni Regini Moran. So can Hamish hold on to a medal position? James Hall currently set in second, 14.325 his score, and Kelvin Cham from the City of Glasgow. That clean routine earned him 13.575, and he currently sits in third place.
time, equaling his score in the all-around competition. And good score for him. That takes him into the lead, going into the second half of the quarter-final. Maisie McLuhan, who is second in the all-around junior competition, leads in the bar line by 13.5. Once another lap concludes the warm-up, so we'll look at the next part of the rotation underway. Again, we'll be focusing on bars and floor. Bars and leg are still just finishing off. The head judge will control that.
So gymnasts just concluding their final preparations.
In the meantime, we're ready over on the floor. Our first competitor for the City of Berlin is Dominic Cunningham.
But it looks like we're now ready to go on the floor for the City of Birmingham's Dominic Cunningham. And a fantastic opening tumble, 1.5 twist punch double. Oh, and a lovely double twisting double back as he goes back across the floor. Really good form in the air, managed to hold on to that tuck nice and tightly.
Next competitor representing Lars, Louise McColgan.
And Dom showing off his abilities on the pommel horse whilst on the floor. These City of Birmingham boys really do have a great style on this piece of apparatus, trying to give their routines that extra flourish. Big double Arabian, doesn't even need the full length of the floor to tuck that tumble in. And the 1-3 rollout with 1.5 twist. Just one more tumble to go. A big puff of the cheeks. A very controlled effort into a triple twisted finish off. Fantastic landing to put an exclamation mark on the end of that routine. A great effort from Dominic Cunningham. Over now, back to the senior women's vault competition. Claudia Fragapani from Bristol Hawks. She's got to have her eyes set on this title. She's popped her difficulty up as 5'8 for the first vault, so that's going to be a double twisting Yachenko that we're so used to seeing from her. And wrap that twist in nice and tightly, straight down the middle of that vault landing, landed directly on the central line, just a pace backwards. The judges are really going to be thinking about Claudia's form in the air. You can just see there's a tiny little bit of loose leggedness and maybe even a little bit of legs crossing too while she's rotating. But no doubting the height and power in her vaulting. She's a very dynamic competitor. Whilst Claudia prepares for her second vault, we've got Georgia May Fenton getting ready to go on the bars. She was the top competitor from yesterday's junior competition on this apparatus. So we'll be sure to bring you her score as soon as she's finished her routine. The vault judges look like they've tapped in their first score for Claudia, 14-7 for that double twisting Yachenko. So 5-6, the difficulty of her next vault. She'll be opting for the Yachenko entry once again, but making that half turn onto the table in her first flight. And what a landing, really solid on that second vault. Yachenko entry half on, pike front half off. Claudia's definitely growing in confidence with this piece of apparatus, and we're hoping she'll be adding more difficulty in the very near future. Right now though, Christian Thomas, we didn't manage to bring you any of his routines yesterday. He only competed over 4 pieces of apparatus, but I'm pretty sure he medalled on every single one of those, so it should be a spectacular floor. hear the applause there in the arena. That's for Georgia May Fenton, who I can tell you has gone smoothly through her bar routine. Really lovely, clean effort for her there. That's going to be a tough one for any of our junior competitors to beat. Right now, though, over on floor, we've got the scoring for Dominic Cunningham, 15.075. So we're ready now to see Christian Thomas from Earls Gymnastics. Christian, a tall but powerful worker here on this piece of apparatus. And starts with whip to double pike Arabian. Oh, a very ambitious first tumble, but unfortunately just not quite able to make it to his feet. Lovely control though on that twisting pass. 2.5 twist, punch straight half, across the floor. And that a lovely skill. A little bit of applause from the audience. They love it when they see something a bit different from these gymnasts. And Christian competently through his circles, low to the floor. Big puff of the cheeks as Christian gets ready for this final tumble. Rounds off, double Arabian. Oh, and just like the first one, not quite enough juice to get round. This time the double Arabian in the tuck position, but that's going to be a costly error. Two falls, two marks lost. And I think that's going to take him out of contention for a medal here today. Back over we go then to the senior women's vault competition. And next up, we've got Kelly Sim from Dynamo. 5.6 put up as her first difficulty value for a vault. Kelly opting for Yuchenko, half on, straight half off. And actually a very good vault. Nice and dynamic, got good distance from the table and directly down that central line. Now unusual that, we're used to seeing Kelly doing her double twisting Yuchenko for her first vault. Ah, but in fact, different difficulty today. So just 5 put up as the value for her second vault. Be expecting to see a full twisting Yuchenko then. Maybe they felt that the Yuchenko half-on vault is a cleaner one for her. Of course, it's always a balance here between difficulty and execution. The judges and coaches work together to decide what the best possible combination of vaults is to put out. And we've got some real superstars preparing around this arena now. Dan Purvis is going to be our next gymnast on the floor. Meanwhile, over on the bars, Catherine Lyons, our consummate junior champion, is just preparing the bars. And there we go, this first score in for Kelly, 14.5. She'll be looking for a stuck landing on this full twisting Yuchenko, though. If she wants to contend for this title, this is going to be a very clean vault indeed. Not a bad effort. Bent her arms quite a lot as she went in for a block there. Maybe compromised her height and distance a little bit. But back over to Daniel Purvis on the floor, our first look today at our new men's senior all-round champion. Ooh. And just bounding forwards there, out of the floor. Too much energy this time for Dan. That tumble, always so impressive. Handspring double front, just across the side of the floor. But completely solid on that twisting combination. So composed and is pressed to wide arm handstand. Now ready for that rollout skill that we love to see from Dan. There we go, beautiful. Standing up with those straight legs, no need to use his hands for assistance. Just carries the energy of that tumble right through to the corner. and a double Arabian to finish, and a stuck landing for Dan. A fantastic routine. Okay, so we haven't got any senior women's vaults left to go. So we get the opportunity to see our junior all-around champion, Catherine Lyons, take to the bars. Now, is she going to go for her extra difficulty today? Shapoznikova, oh yeah, oh no, not going for it. So we're used to seeing her attempting a release from that combination, but sky high on the ginger. Cleanly through her forward gianting elements. A beautiful shoot half down to the low bar, landing right in vertical. Lovely giant fall, quick adjustment of the hands, getting ready for the big dismount. Arabian double front dismount, just a pace forward on the landing. I think it's going to be tight, but that's going to be tough to challenge Georgia May's efforts from just a couple of routines ago. And from one Europa gymnast to another. Now, Gianni seems to have a new leotard for today. Gianni Regini Moran, his initials are across the back of that there. It's pretty cool. Just have your name across the back of your Leo. He's a supremely confident gymnast on this piece of apparatus, and rightly so. Just looks so confident with all of his work here. And there's been plenty of support from the Europa Gymnastics Club over the course of this weekend. Plenty of spectators here in the crowd. Really been getting behind their gymnast, which is always lovely to see. The score for Daniel Purvis then, 15.05. He's laid down the gauntlet for Gianni. So, can he meet the challenge? So, Gianni's score on floor in the all-around competition was 15.45. So if he goes clean here, we could have our Masters champion. And you can hear that warm welcome from our crowd here in the Liverpool Echo Arena. Judge is still not quite ready though, still showing the red light. Here we go now though, green light on, signalling they are ready for Gianni. Gianni starts from the middle of the floor area. Always think it's so impressive. Huge double Arabian half out. That just pops right off the floor, practically in the rafters of the arena here at the Echo. And an incredible double twisting, double tuck, so secure on that landing. Handspring, 2.5 twist. Perfect form in the air and chest upright on the landing. Gianni always moves so quickly through his routine, but does have to hold that handstand for 2 seconds in order to meet that requirement. He's got so many tumbles to pack into this routine. At the English Championships, he was moving a little bit too slowly and went over time. But he's really powering through this routine today. One more tumble to go. And there's the buzzer, 10 seconds left to pack it in. Rounds off, triple twist, just a pace back on the landing, but a fantastic routine there. Not many deductions whatsoever, huge difficulty, and he's definitely laid down his challenge there. And so the scoring for Catherine Lyons on the bars, 13.6. So, yep, Georgia May Fenton stays in gold medal position. But we've now got our final competitor from the academy, Abigail Solari. Lovely clear hip linked directly into a Katchev. A little bit late in that full turning giant. The judges are really looking for those pirouetting skills to be finishing directly on top of the bar. She's working hard now, looking a little bit laboured in her casts. But making the turn, forward giant, And double tuck dismount. Oh, she looked like she was round then, just couldn't quite get her shoulders over the top of her feet, and unfortunately sitting down that dismount. Abby was the last competitor in this bars final, so we'll soon be able to confirm the results there. Meanwhile, I can now confirm the results of the women's vault final. Taking the gold medal is going to be Claudia Fragapani, 14.35 her total. Coming in second place, oh, in fact, it looks like a joint second place here, both Kelly Sim and Ellie Downey earning 14.175 for their efforts. We're still waiting for the scores to come in from Gianni. Should be any second now. Looks like all of our judges have tapped in their totals. And there we go, a picture-perfect score. Just the same as he scored in the all-around final yesterday. 15.45 makes Gianni Regini Moran our Masters Floor Champion. What a title for Gianni to take. 15.45 truly is an international level type of routine. His difficulty value 6.7, 0.3 ahead of any of the other guys in that final, so huge difficulty combined with great execution. Definitely a worthy champion here on the floor. Over in the women's junior bar final, the score is now in for Abigail Solari, 11.6 for her after unfortunately sitting down that dismount. So we have got our medalist confirmed. In third place, Maisie Mathewin from Phoenix Gymnastics, 13.25. In second place with a score of 13.6, our all-around champion, Catherine Lyons from Europa. And in first place, gorgeous form on this apparatus, beautiful open shoulder angles and some fantastic daring releases too. 13.95 her score and earns her the gold medal here on the bars.
Moving over to the women's senior apparatus final for the vault. We have
So the lights are down, we are ready to bring out our gymnasts for the next apparatus finals.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome in the finalists of Wayne.
I think this time we're going to be seeing the senior women coming out on the bars, the junior women taking to the beam. And our men's masters finalists will be treating us to a spectacular show on the pole vault. And our final group to be brought out in this rotation, our junior women on the beam. Our top qualifier here, of course, was Catherine Lyons. She was a European finalist on this piece of apparatus in 2014. And yesterday, she was miles ahead of the competition, 0.9 separating her from Lucy Stanhope, City Liverpool, who placed second in qualifying. Beam, always a tough test though for these junior gymnasts. It really will be a case of who can stay on the apparatus today. However, you've got to like Catherine's chances. 5.8 was her difficulty score in yesterday's competition, which was the highest by around 0.3. So as long as she can stay on the beam today, you've got to fancy her for taking home the goals.
So as the lights come up, back to the action.
Now I will draw your attention also to our men's pommel horse final. This is always one of the fantastic events here in the Masters Gymnastics. So the Masters Gymnastics is a combination of the under 16, under 18 and senior competitors from the previous day's competition. Generally speaking though, the majority of our competitors come from the senior competition. Occasionally you get some under 18s that sneak into the action. But here today we have got Jamie Lewis, our under 16 champion, just 14 years of age, and he's going to be pitching his pommel work up against the likes of Lewis Smith, Olympic medalist. This is a really special opportunity for him, and what a day. You've got to think that this young gymnast has got a lot to bring in the next couple of years. Incredible to see that he's got his sufficient difficulty and execution to be competing against the very best in Britain, and not only in Britain, but also in the world. And in fact, it looks like we're going to have to wait until another day until we get that battle of the double downies. Becky hasn't come out onto the competition floor, so I'm not sure what that's down to. I know she was struggling with the apparatus yesterday and obviously had a bit of a challenging time on beam. But it does mean we've got a tough battle at the top. We've got our two first-year seniors, Taisha Mattis and Ellie Downey, who are going to be going head-to-head. Right now, though, we're going to start our competition over on Pommel Horse with the men. And Courtney Tullock from Pegasus is going to be the first gymnast to take to the apparatus. Now, we discussed yesterday that pommel probably isn't Courtney's favourite piece of apparatus, but he's clearly done well here this weekend, qualifying for this Masters final. And showing lovely work, pressing cleanly up to handstand on the one handle. Courtney really clean in his circling elements, showing great prowess on the single handle there as well, going for the spindle turn. Gymnasts have to travel the length of the horse during the course of their routine, and Courtney doing so. pressing confidently into his dismount. Just a single turn as he travels the length of the horse. A fantastically clean and solid start for Courtney. We're now going to be going over to bars to join our first competitor in the senior competition. And it looks like it's going to be Charlie Fellows from the City of Liverpool starting off on the bars today. This Charlie's only final. Charlie was ninth all around yesterday, 50.85 her total, but really did excel here on the bars. 13.45 was the score there, and our highest score on any apparatus yesterday, so she'll be hoping to put in a good performance for this home crowd. Charlie just taking a second to compose herself before mounting the apparatus. Looking very focused as she mounts the bars. Upstart straddle cast on the low bar, straight into a Stolder Shapasnikova. Cleanly linked back to the pack somersault down to the low bar. Charlie obviously favouring these Shap skills, but not quite getting enough of a backswing there. Ooh, and a real shame. Just lost a rhythm there in that routine, was hoping to link directly from the Shap back into a shoot half. Had to take an extra swing to build up a bit more energy, and she's going to be disappointed. This is her only final here today, so she'd have been hoping to put in a clean performance on the bars. When the gymnasts come away from the apparatus, they have 30 seconds to remount. Charlie's just going to be wanting to finish this routine cleanly now. And a lovely release there. One that we haven't seen recently from many of our British gymnasts. Winding up now for a dismount. And a big double straight somersault. Lovely difficulty late on in the routine. But unfortunately that mount, that fall early on really is going to impede her score.
11.7 on B. But your rope will be Catherine Lyons.
And over on the pommel horse, we now get to see our under 16 champion.
Woking, Jamie Lewis.
Jamie Lewis competes for Woking Gymnastics Club, and as I say, just 14 years of age. Won't be turning 15 until September this year. He's done incredibly well to even make this final. His score in the all-around on pommel horse was 14.05. This is a big test for him now, competing against the senior competitors. And lovely flare work there from Jamie. A ripple of applause from the audience. Really appreciating that challenging work. Lovely Magia travel. Back down the horse with Shivado. Lovely circling on one handle and oh, just lost the rhythm, pressing up into that dismount. He makes the turn. He'd done so well through that routine. Just a small mistake at the end, but a fantastic showing for this 14-year-old in the Masters final. I can tell you that Catherine Lyons has gone cleanly through her beam routine so far. And a lovely 2.5 distance dismount. I'm sure that effort won't have done her chance of this beam title any harm whatsoever. Over on senior women's bars though, we have got Claudia Fragapani coming up from Bristol Hawks. Now Claudia's routine in qualifying wasn't faultless. She put in her new church release, but unfortunately caught her feet on the apparatus, just coming in a little bit close to the bar. She'll be looking to correct that mistake today and maybe move up the rankings. So it's going to come straight off the top after this piked Jaeger. We'll see, feet on the bar, big catch, and much cleaner today. Brilliant work from Fragapani. linking the toe-on pike catchev, the church, directly into her pack somersault down to the low bar. Ooh, and quite late on that turn, toe-on full. The gymnasts have to show a full turn on the bars. But a lovely double straight somersault, quite a large lunge forward on the landing. That's going to cost her 0.3. But I'm sure she'll be happy to have got through that routine a little bit more cleanly than yesterday, making that connection, successfully performing her church, and that's going to be a bigger score than we saw in qualifying.
Jamie Lewis scored 12.775.
Jamie Lewis, not quite the score we would have wanted on the pommel horse. 12.775 his score there after that late mistake.
Next to perform will be Jay Thompson from South Essex.
Next though, taking to the pommel horse, we've got South Essex's Jay Thompson. Obviously teammates with Max Whitlock, who's not too shabby on the pommel horse. Fantastic circling work here from Jay, looking incredibly confident. He's got that lovely open body line on the pommel horse. Press up tall and a very quick pirouette in that dismount. Really good work there. Now, you might have heard a score come in midway through that routine for Catherine Lyons on the beam. 14.7. That is a huge score on beam. It'll just be interesting to see if we can take a look at her difficulty versus execution. So 5.9 difficulty for Catherine, 8.8 her execution. That really is a fantastic performance under pressure here in the British Championship Finals. Over in senior women's bar finals though, we're now ready to take a look at Ellie Downey. The score in for Claudia Fragapani, 13.65. And indeed, a big improvement on her score from yesterday. 13 was Claudia's score in the all-around, so 0.65 better today. It was a much cleaner execution and obviously managing to earn more difficulty from her bonuses, linking those skills together early in the routine. And Ellie just taking a second to compose herself there. A moment of quiet and calm in the arena. I'm not actually sure why the judges haven't put their green light on, if they've already processed the score from the last routine. Maybe waiting for the junior to just finish off her beam.
Megan Parker from the City of Birmingham. She's copy.
Claudia Fragapani with a score of 13.65 on the uneven bars.
Ellie always looks like such a cool customer when she's waiting for the judges to signal their readiness.
Our next contenders on those apparatus for the uneven bars representing Notts, Ellie Downey.
She looks like she's got her game
and
face on now.
The City of Glasgow, David
and she's going to be fighting to get through this routine. This is one of the moves that's given her a bit of trouble, but nicely done. The toe on half turn in forward grip. And lovely work there. The shap directly linked into the catchev. Ellie manages to generate really strong swing on her bars. And you can in fact hear Sister Becky from the crowd talking her through this routine, giving her some little cues. Nice shoot handstand. Stole the shoot to the top bar. Winding up now for the big dismount. This routine's gone so well so far. Double straight and a tiny hop on the landing. That was a fantastic routine for Ellie. You can see from the smile on her face, she is delighted with that routine. And a lovely hug as well from Claire Starkey, Notts coach. That really was a fantastic effort on the bars.
Jay Thompson, 13.925. Next to perform.
Back over to pommel horse though.
James Hall.
From Pegasus, we get our second look today at James Hall. James finished joint third in the all-around competition yesterday.
Finalist on beam
and qualified in fourth place for the pommel horse final. Lovely, confident travel down the length of the horse. James working well here, really building his difficulty, keeping good form throughout this routine. Pushing up tall into his dismount, lovely pirouette, just brought the legs together, pulled in that turn, and a lovely clean effort from James Hall. It's going to be so difficult to contend with some of these world-class competitors here on the pommel, though. Of course, we've still got Lewis Smith, Olympic medalist, still to come. As well as Lewis Smith, we have got Max Whitlock, who knows a thing or two about pommel horse. So there's still some big names to come in this pommel final. We're just going to be waiting for a couple of minutes here whilst the beam judges allow Amelia Montague from Tolworth to finish off her beam routine. Very respectful of the judges to allow the junior gymnast to finish their routines before they ask the senior gymnast to proceed. 14.15 was the score for Ellie Downey over on the bars.
14.15, our next competitor there, final of this slip warm-up, representing the City of Liverpool.
That currently puts Ellie in first place. But right now, a fantastic roar from the crowd as Jade Stedford from the City of Liverpool takes to the bars. Lots of home crowd support here for Jade. And she performed a beautiful routine yesterday. Jade's got lovely long lines on this piece of apparatus. She's quite a tall gymnast, but that really makes all of these stalls of close bar elements look really beautiful. Lovely height in that transition, generating plenty of swing up onto the top bar. Stalled a fall, finishing right on top of the bars. Oh, and such a shame. Linked it directly into a release and catch, but just unable to quite get her hands around that bar. These gymnasts are all trying really hard to build their difficulty, going for difficult connections to earn extra bonus. But unfortunately, sometimes they just don't quite come off. The second beep signalling that Jay's just got 10 seconds to remount the apparatus. She goes. There can't have been much left in this routine. She's going to be disappointed to have fallen at the last hurdle. There we go. She's got to show a forward element. Does so with a beautiful endo directly into a double front dismount. Oh, and just not enough rotation once again. Two falls for Jade. That's going to be incredibly costly, but some lovely promising work there for the future. She was the final competitor in this half of the rotation, so we're going to be welcoming our second half of the final to warm up. And we've still got some big routines to come. I've already alluded to the Masters finals on the pommel horse. We've got Sam Oldham, Max Whitlock, Lewis Smith, all still to come. Whilst over on the women's bars, Taisha Mattis, our second place qualifier, our all-around champion, Amy Tinkler, and also Rhea Fika from Cardiff Central, who's got some lovely work on this apparatus. So the score came in for Amelia Montague over on the beam. She slotted in second place, 12.7 her score. Not a bad effort, but I'm sure we've seen her score higher than that in the past. However, 2 marks in the lead, a clear 2 marks ahead of second place. Catherine Lyons with that spectacular routine, 14.7. And actually, I think that's going to be a really challenging total for anyone to surpass here today. So it looks like the junior gymnasts are ready to start off and beam. The guys and girls on pommel horse just taking a little bit longer about their warm-up. That's because the gymnasts get the opportunity to alter the apparatus in between each of the warm-ups. On pommel horse, the men can change the distance that the pommels are apart from each other, just to make sure they're well placed for their shoulder width. Whilst over on the bars, some of our gymnasts need the bars raising because they're that little bit taller. And get the opportunity to apply a bit of chalk as well before they mount the apparatus. Can tell you there, Louise McColgan going smoothly through her beam.
Gymnast on a pommel horse was the silver medalist in the under 16 all-around competition.
See Rhea Fika just putting the final touches there to her preparations. But we are going to be starting this rotation off on the pommel horse, and it's going to be Joshua Nathan from the city of Birmingham.
Joshua Nathan.
Josh is another one of our under 16 competitors, did incredibly well to make it through to this Masters final. Just 15 years of age. Working confidently through this routine. Really precise about those hand placements. He travels the length. Oh, and what a shame. He was doing so well up until that point, but unfortunately just lost his rhythm a little bit on that turn on the end of the horse. Pommel horse really is the men's equivalent to the beam. Once you've let yourself drift away from the apparatus, it's incredibly difficult to pull it back. But back into confident circling work, hips held high above the horse and turning so well in that dismount. Fantastic pirouetting skill. Holds his head up high following his landing. He's going to be disappointed with himself for that fall, but as an under 16 in this Masters final, that was a fantastic performance.
On the uneven bars, we have representing South Durham.
Now, over on the bars, though, we have South Durham's Amy Tinkler, our all-around champion from yesterday.
And on the wings, representing Jersey, is James Lair.
And she had some great work on this piece of apparatus yesterday. Getting straight into it, toe on shap, directly linked into her pack somersault down to the low bar. Beautiful handstand on the low bar. And a confident shap half. Ooh, not sure what she was going for there. Can't work out if she was trying to work into a forward element or just mistimed a pirouette, but that's a real shame. Huge catch up above the bar. Lovely to see the gymnast flying so high. And this time she makes that turn into a forward giant. Winding up now, full twisting double tuck. A fantastic dismount, just lost herself a little bit there in the middle of the routine. And that is definitely going to be costly here in this final. You'll be able to hear some floor music in the background right now. We've currently got Sophie Crawford, one of our disability gymnasts, going through her routine. We are going to be keeping our focus on the senior and masters finals. So our next gymnast on the pommel horse from South Essex, Max Whitlock, Olympic medalist here on the pommel horse and also in the team competition. Of course, silver medalist in the all-round at last year's World Championships. This unfortunately the only piece of apparatus he's competing this weekend. Max suffered a small injury at the English Championships to one of his quadricep muscles. Had a bit of a difficult time there on the leg apparatus, so opting just to compete here on the pommel today. and a confident start to his routine. Wouldn't expect to see anything else from Max. Lovely turns on the single handle there. So confident with these hand placements. This is the bit where he struggled yesterday, but not so today. Beautiful work. Max always shows such good extension. Got beautiful leg form and pointed toes throughout his routine. And much better today. Really good travel along the length of the horse. Really just the dismount now left to go. Not the most difficult routine we've seen from Max. Could have put some more pirouettes into that dismount, but a confident and clean performance here today. He's certainly going to be looking for a space on that medal podium. Over on the bars now, a really nice opportunity here for Rebecca Moore. She was the 9th place gymnast in the bars score table yesterday. But as Becky Downey's removed herself from the final, then Rebecca's got this opportunity to compete today.
Amy Tinkler scoring 13.3. Our next competitor representing Phoenix is Rebecca Moore. On rims we have Aaron Bonner from Jersey.
Rebecca just 17 years of age and competing for Phoenix Gymnastics Club. You can just hear there her Welsh teammates talking her through this routine. Lacking a bit of swing on that shap, the judges are able to deduct if the backswing doesn't come up horizontal with the bar. And a big kick into her Katchev, cleanly caught. Shoot half, just a little bit untidy with her legs. Judges will be taking all these little deductions when the legs come apart or they have a slight bend. Oh, what a lovely dismount. Don't see too many of those. Lovely straight back with a double twist. Very confident in the air. And a good routine for Rebecca here in this final. The score for Max on pommel horse, 15.825. Now, that's going to be a real challenge, actually. I think Lewis's score yesterday for the gold was 15.8. Oh, sorry, I stand corrected, 15.5. So he's really laid down the gauntlet here for his British teammate. Our next gymnast is going to be Loughborough student Sam Oldham. He qualified in second to this Masters Pommel Horse final. His score yesterday was 14.6, so he's really going to have to up his score today if he wants to challenge for the title. I think you've got to think though that Max Whitlock and Lewis Smith are going to be really the two that are fighting for the gold here. Ready now for Sam Oldham. Cleanly through his sheer work at the beginning of his routine. Real confident work there on the single handle before he starts in his travelling elements. Fabulous quick hands as he moves through this routine. So Sam doing really well to build. Oh, his difficulty, and what a shame. So he's not going to get the full value of that dismount. Really had to use his strength to get into that handstand, but real appreciation from the crowd for the strength he showed in that routine. Across to bars now, though, we've got Taisha Mattis from East London. Taisha was the second place qualifier yesterday behind Becky Downey, so without Becky in this final, she's really going to be pushing to take this senior bars title. Taisha's score yesterday was 14.45. She had some really daring release combinations, and she'll be hoping to go cleanly through them again today. Currently the top score on bars, 14.35 from Claudia Fragapani. And right off the top, clear hip shap, directly linked back into the pack somersault. But this is where it starts to get really wild. Shap half. Clear hip fall, directly into Katchev, into Ginger. And a fantastic catch there. Never a doubt in Taisha's mind she was going to make that combination. And kicks up, double front dismount, just a hop forward on the landing. That was a confident performance from Taisha. Made it look quite easy that in the end, didn't she? So Taisha's only worked across two pieces of apparatus here at these championships. She's of course a solid all-round gymnast. We'll be hoping to see her back on all four very soon. However, over on Pommel Horse, we have got the one and only Lewis Smith waiting for the judges to give him the green light. The score in for Sam Alden, 13-6. So a little bit down on yesterday after that struggle with his dismount. So, the real story here then, can Lewis challenge Max and take this gold medal away from him? Lewis's score yesterday, 15-5. The gauntlet just laid down by Max, 15-8-2-5. So Lewis really is going to have to be clean here today. Saying that, he did say he'd got some stuff left in the bag. He said he'd got some more difficulty that he could put into this routine should he need to. And you've got to think that he might be considering that now with Max having performed such a strong routine. A roar here in the Liverpool Echo Arena for the one and only Lewis Smith. And a quick start to Lewis's routine. Sheer up to the handstand on a single handle. Cleanly through. Lewis has got to pull out all the stops here if he wants this gold medal. It feels like Lewis has sped up a little bit today. He's normally got quite a slow circling technique, but almost looks a little bit like he's in fast forward compared to his routine yesterday. And a fantastic dismount there, so clean, supremely confident in that landing. and you can see from the smile on his face, he's pretty happy with that performance. So he couldn't have done much more than that in terms of execution. That was a great routine, but is it going to be enough to surpass the total set down by Max Whitlock? Right now though, over on senior bars, we've got Rhea Fika. Rhea was sixth in the all-around competition yesterday. Working well through this bar routine. A little bit low on the catch-up, but cleanly through that full turn. Finished right on top of the bar. Ooh, and let go really quite early on that dismount. You can see just how far she travelled away from the bar. Not quite getting the height that she'd like to see, but nevertheless, another clean routine. So that concludes yet another final here in Liverpool. We'll soon be able to confirm the results for you. But we're still waiting for that score to come through from Lewis. It should be any second now. 15-8-2-5, the score to beat from Max. Certainly the smile after his routine, he looked pretty confident that he was going to achieve the total he needed. Judges really taking their time, making sure they get this score right. It's always so tight at the top in our pommel horse finals here in Great Britain. Just got so many gymnasts of world-class ability on this piece of apparatus. The scoring system's telling me that there's 75% of the score has been tabulated. Just waiting for those final scores to be punched into the system. There we go, it looks like it should be any second now. All of the judges have submitted their scores. Just waiting for the final total to be confirmed. And there we go, 15.975 for Lewis Smith. A fantastic routine. So close to hitting that elusive 16 mark, and it looks like our Masters champion for 2015 on the pommel horse is going to be the one and only Lewis Smith. So still plenty of gymnastics to come here in Liverpool. We have of course got our junior, senior women, as well as our disability and masters gymnast competing here. On the live stream, we are going to continue to follow the senior men and women. However, just to let you know, if you are wanting to catch up with any of the other action, we will be uploading apparatus videos for all of our contenders across the different apparatus here today. And there's also the opportunity to follow on the individual judge cams. So if you can go to the British Gymnastics Championship homepage, there's the opportunity to select which apparatus you'd like to watch. You can also choose which angle you'd like to watch from on some of them, and you can catch all of the action there. So if you'd rather watch a different piece of apparatus to the one that we're following on the stream, then you can choose to do so there. If you're looking for any of the links to those alternative pages, then please do check out the British Gymnastics Twitter, where you can get all the information on where to watch. And finally,
Disability gymnasts on vault, as well as the men's masters finalists on the rink. Failure to launch with that one. Seems to be one extreme or the other with this t-shirt cannon. Either goes for miles or barely gets out the end of the gun.
Oh,
crowd really going wild for this t-shirt cannon, desperate to get their hands on some merchandise from this event. And John definitely loving the power of the t-shirt cannon. I think this might even be his favourite part of the competition here today. Starting off this rotation on the rings. Courtney Tulloch from Pegasus was part of the British team who went to the World Championships last year and actually got himself a skill named after him on this piece of apparatus. As we said, had some struggles yesterday, qualified lower down than we're used to seeing him, but I'm sure I'll be hoping to put that right today and straight off the top, so confident in that first planche position. Showing the jitters exactly how this should be done. Perfect strength holds. You'll often see the gymnasts not quite managing to achieve the desired line, maybe letting their feet drop, but there you go, once again, a fantastic horizontal hold from Courtney. Such a strong performer on this piece of apparatus. You've got to think now that his muscles will be burning, the lactic acid's building up from all of those holds. And yet still he continues to perform so well. He's got a pull-up tall to hold that handstand. And full twist and double straight dismount. Just a pace back on the landing. But that was a fantastic performance. And as he punches the air, you know he's delighted with that routine. We're going to take this opportunity now to cross over to one of our disability competitors on the vault. 10.75 was the score just in for James Lang. So we're getting ready now to see his second vault. Looks like our judges are just calling the control desk. Okay, so just got a slight technical issue here on the vault. Judges just struggling a little bit with the system. I'm sure all familiar with the computer systems having their moments. But there we go, technical difficulty sorted. Now ready for James Lang's second vault. And a nicely performed handspring there. Just a pace back on the landing. But a great clean performance for James. Over on rings, we're still just waiting for the score to come in for Courtney Tulloch. Courtney might have been the first up in this final. He was the lowest qualifier to this Masters rings final. But I'm sure he'll be pushing up the standings today. can see all of the judges over by the rings just collaborating with one another, making sure that they've got all of those really difficult elements counted in Courtney's routine. With all of the strength holds, the gymnasts are required to show the desired position completely static for at least 2 seconds in order for the judges to be able to give full difficulty. And of course, when the gymnasts perform difficult skills back to back, there's the opportunity for them to build their difficulty through connection bonuses. And Courtney certainly managed a lot of that in that routine, so the judges will just be looking to make sure they get it right. The score for Courtney, 15-4-5. I think that's going to be a very challenging total for anyone to surpass. The highest score in the senior competition yesterday was 14-9-5 from Dan Purvis, so a much better routine from Courtney today. Right now though, James Hall from Pegasus. And another lovely planche position there. But a little bit high in the shoulders in that cross. You can really just see the difference between Courtney's and James' routines there. The quality of the strength positions, just not quite as stable here for James. But a very calm look on his face as he holds those incredibly difficult positions. Into his swinging work now. The gymnasts have to show at least one static handstand in their routine. Giant back to handstand and double twisting, double back dismount. Fantastic spatial awareness there on that move. Okay, so we've just got the opportunities now to look back at the vault. This was David Ray. Was a fantastic effort. A big tucked Sukahara. Just a pace back on the landing, but really fantastic difficulty in this disability final. I think we're going to have the opportunity to stay here and watch the second vault. For David Ray. This time it was handspring, half turn off, and a really solid two volts there for David. As we come straight into Lee Davidson. Cleanly performed handspring. Just slightly bent elbows to push off the table, little hop forward on the landing. But very confident over the vaulting table. Now we're going to be crossing back over to the rings, fresh from his victory on the floor. We've got Gianni Regini Moran from Europa. Gianni's score on the rings in the all-around competition was 13-9. To improve on that today. Very high in the straddle planche, but you can just see not quite holding those strength positions completely still. The digs are looking for complete control on the rings. So difficult while the rings are moving independently from the gymnast. Really got to try and apply that force directly down onto the rings, keep them still. Into his gianting work now. Full twisting, double tuck dismount, half in, half out, nicely done, and solid on that landing. Certainly not the same level of difficulty we've seen from some of our other competitors, but I'm sure he'll be happy to have another clean routine in the bank. We're now going to get a chance to look at Lee Davison's second vault. So we really saw that first handspring. So second effort, got to go onto the table in a slightly different way. Oh, and now I think that's the first vault again, so that was his handspring. And it looks like we've just got one more gymnast to go in this half of the rotation. Our silver medalist in the all-round yesterday, Frank Baines. So Frank now looking like a confident senior gymnast, but of course very familiar with his work coming up through the age groups and as a junior gymnast. Had a very successful time at the Junior Europeans back in 2012, where he was in fact the all-around champion. Since then he's suffered with a little bit of injury. He's worked incredibly hard to get back to full fitness and competition. Last year we saw him really back to full fitness for the first time in a couple of years. In the 2014 British Championships, he placed third on floor before going on to be a member of that Scottish Commonwealth team who won the historic silver medal. But ready now to go in this Masters final on the rings. See him already just shaking in that first strength position. Doing well there to lift his feet, trying to make that hold completely horizontal. Of course, the judges watching from the side of the apparatus, so they've got the perfect view of those planche type holds. Oh, and working really hard, pushing up tall through his arms to make sure of that handstand. And better this time round. Much more stable, going into the forward element, double pike directly into a straddle planche. He really is working hard on this piece of apparatus. Double tuck directly into, double pike dismount, but unfortunately just not quite able to keep that on his feet. Maybe a little bit tired after the all-around competition last night, not that long ago. It is incredibly busy weekend for these gymnasts. But that does bring to a conclusion the first half of this rotation. So we're going to be welcoming the second half of our competitors on the men's rings and the disability vault to take their warm-up. So back over to the men's masters final on the rings. We've got Jamie Lewis, our under 16 champion. Really quite remarkable to see one of our under 16 competitors in this rings final. Rings typically easier for the more mature gymnasts who've had the opportunity to build a little bit more muscle. But clearly, Jamie showing some early potential on this piece. Working well there, favouring the swinging work, maybe over some of the more difficult strength holds. Holding a strong and confident handstand on the rings. Oh, and having to squeeze tight to hold that one. Come on, Jamie, push up tall. Getting ready now for his dismount. Full twisting, double straight. I don't think he's going to be challenging for a medal here today. The difficulty somewhat down on our other competitors. But once again, showing that he has got some great potential for the future. So in this Masters final, we've still currently got Courtney Tullock in the lead. Set that impressive 15.45 in the first routine. To give you an idea of the difference though, 6.7 was the difficulty score for Courtney in that first routine. Just waiting for the score to come through now for Jamie, but I think it'll go to show the difference in difficulty between these two gymnasts. Obviously Jamie performing a great clean routine in qualifying to get through to this Masters final. The score through for Jamie Lewis, 13.45, but his difficulty just 5.0. So before they kind of even started on the execution, Courtney Tullock had 1.7 higher start value than Jamie Lewis. So a really well executed routine for Jamie, but it's not going to be enough to earn him a medal here today. Now over on the rings, Christian Thomas from Earls. Had a really good performance in this piece of apparatus in the all-around competition yesterday. And lovely double tuck through to that straddle planche, but he really has got quite a swing on now on the rings. It's always so difficult to bring them back under control when they're swinging that much. But Christian handling it nicely. And as soon as they go into those swinging elements, they can bring them back under control. Christian doing so very well. And a solid handstand now on top of the rings. Winding up for his dismount. Full twisting, double straight, and what a landing. Feet glued together. And not the smallest shuffle on the floor. Really good work there from Christian. Get a chance to go back over to our disability fault vinyl now. This Alexander Boosman. And a really nicely performed handspring there. Arms high up by the shoulders, lovely straight arms throughout. Just a small pace in the landing, but that was a very nicely performed vault indeed. waiting for the score to come through for Christian Thomas. Oh, and there we go, 14.3 puts him into second place currently in the Masters Rings final. Next up though, Sam Oldham from Loughborough Students Gymnastics Club. His coach just making sure he's secure on the apparatus at the start of his routine. And pushing it strongly into that planche. You can just see though, unlike some of the other routines we've had, feet were quite low. Not so on that crucifix though. Fantastic position there. And started high in that straddle planche, but feet just dropping a little. But Sam, really good in those cross positions. Lovely straight line between both wrists. Not too high in the shoulders. And good control in that handstand. Big double back somersaults. And squeezing really tight to hold onto that handstand. Just a little bit of an angle through his shoulders. And double twisting, double tuck to finish. A lovely full stop at the end of that routine. A little bit of strain on his face following that routine, but a fantastic routine for Sam. So we're going to get a chance now to look back at Alexander Buznell's second vault. Looked very confident down the runway, and it was a handspring half off for his second vault. Lovely and clean through the air. Again, that nice open shoulder angle and a fantastic vault for Alexander. So the score in for Sam Oldham, 14.675, which means we've just got one competitor left to go on the rings. And from the city of Birmingham, we get another opportunity to take a look at Dominic Cunningham. You can see Lee Walls, the coach from the city of Birmingham club, just popping Dom up on the rings. He's had an incredibly successful weekend in all the different age groups. And Dom really favouring that straight planche position. The male competitors can repeat strength elements as long as they get into them from a different entry. But as well as those strength skills, they have to show swinging too. Okay, double pike, double tuck forwards. And fighting to control the rings now. Full twisting, double somersault this one. I think he intended for that to be straight all the way around, but really just had to tuck the legs in for that landing. I'm not sure he's going to be a contender for a medal here today. But another routine, clearly in the bag. I think it's safe to say that our first competitor, Corey Pollock, is going to be our champion here on the rings today. 15.45, that huge score laid down in the very first routine. And definitely a worthy winner.
Is David Ray in the silver medal position with a score of 11.15. From Jersey is Alexander Busnell, and in the bronze medal position with a score of 10.75, also representing Jersey, is James Lang.
And to the results in the Masters Rings Final. Winner of the title with a score of 15.45, Courtney Tullock. Winner of the silver medal with 14.675. Sam Oldham, and the bronze with a score of 14.3 will be awarded to Christian Thomas.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are just minutes away from getting our medal ceremony underway, so don't go anywhere.
Yeah! So we are going to have the first half of our medal ceremonies. Conclusion of the first two senior and junior women's apparatus and the first three for our men's masters finals. Also, we're going to have our disability gymnasts receiving their medals for their efforts so far. The arena staff will be busily organising the gymnasts out the back of the arena, getting them all ready to march in for the apparatus finals. The atmosphere in the Liverpool Echo Arena really has been fantastic right across the weekend. It was a huge crowd yesterday, making lots of noise for our gymnasts. And again today, a slightly smaller crowd, but definitely getting behind our athletes. And there you go, you can just get a sneak peek backstage there. All of our gymnasts being lined up, ready to come out for the medal presentations. There we've got our senior vault medalists. Just checking all of the gymnasts are there in the right order. Do remember that you can check out YouTube for routine uploads from some of our disability competitors who haven't been able to feature so far this morning. Also, if you've got access to GymNet, you can log in using your username and password, and the judge cam videos are available to watch as soon as the gymnasts have finished their performance. Really can see it's a hive of activity backstage, just making sure all of these gymnasts are going to be in the right place at the right time. Nice little wave to the camera there from Dom Cunningham. And you can see the competition organisers just busily trying to make sure they've got the right gymnast in place for each apparatus.
And senior apparatus finals, men's British Masters and disability British Masters is about to commence. Please join me in welcoming our gymnasts to the presentation party.
Bars and floor. whilst we've got three pieces to present for each of our Masters finalists and also our male disability competitors. You can see the presentation party there following out the gymnasts. And the three gymnasts coming out there for the junior medal presentations really have been the superstars of this junior competition this year. They were our top three all-around gymnasts. And they've certainly earned themselves some more silverware here in these finals this afternoon.
Uneven bars final. In third place and winner of the bronze medal representing Phoenix Gymnastics, Maisie Methuen. In second place and winner of the silver medal representing Europa Gym Center, Catherine Lyons.
So kicking off the presentations, we have got the junior women on the bars. And in fact, what they've shown today is an incredible level of consistency. Our top three gymnasts on the bars yesterday are exactly the same as the three today. So fantastic work here from these three gymnasts. Maisie Methuen taking the bronze, Catherine Lyons in second place, but Georgia May Fenton showing exceptional work on the bars. She's got great difficulty on this piece of apparatus, and 13.75, a great total there for her. Georgia's score would have even earned her a place on the senior medal podium on this apparatus, so really goes to show how strong she is here. Lovely to see the gymnasts with such a smile on their face, having been awarded their prizes. As Georgia lifts her trophy high, very well deserved here this weekend. Georgia May Fenton is the junior bars champion.
We will continue with the presentation for the women's senior vault final. In joint second place and winners of the silver medals, representing Knott's Gymnastics Academy and Dynamo School of Gymnastics, Ellie Downey and Kelly Sim.
Moving on now to the senior women's vault final. And in joint second place, Ellie Downey and Kelly Sim, each earning 14.175.
Representing Bristol Hawks Gym Club, the 2015 Women's Senior British Vault Champion is Claudia Fragopani.
But Claudia Fragopani just had too much power for these two competitors. Our reigning Commonwealth Vault Champion takes the gold medal here today. 14.35, just 0.015 ahead of her competitors. They all had very similar difficulty here on the vault, but Claudia did incredibly well here today and deservedly takes the title.
software supplied to British Gymnastics. Ladies and gentlemen, your vault medalists. Thank you, gymnasts.
So congratulations to our senior women's vault medalists.
The next presentation is for the Women's Disability Masters Floor Competition. In third place, and winner of the bronze.
Moving on to our first presentation now for our disability women.
Georgia Castle.
That is the presentation for floor. So in third place from the City of Glasgow Gymnastics Club, Georgia Carslaw. In second place with a score of 10.6 from The Wire, Natasha Coates. But the disability champion on the floor from the City of Glasgow, Sophie Crawford. Very well deserved here today, 10.95 her total. Had really good difficulty here on the floor exercise. Was almost a mark higher than her competitors on her difficulty value. So definitely a well-deserved gold medal for Sophie. And she definitely looks happy to be up on the top of that medal rostrum. As they just receive a final well done from the presentation party. Incredible work there from those three girls.
We move now to the presentation for the Women's Junior B final. In third place, and winner of the bronze medal, representing Large GC, Louise McColgan.
So going to our junior women now, and this time looking at the B. Louise McColgan, our bronze medalist. But coming back to the podium for the second time so far today, Maisie Methuen takes home the silver medal on B.
Winner of the gold medal, representing Europa Gym Centre, the 2015 Women's Junior British B champion is Catherine Lyons.
But this really was a routine to watch. It's going to be interesting to see if any of the senior competitors can surpass her total here today. 14.7, a huge score on beam for Catherine Lyons. She had a couple of wobbles yesterday, but clearly managed to iron out some of the wrinkles here today. Must have been an incredibly solid routine to earn that score. 5.9 her difficulty, 8.8 her execution. We always like to say that the gymnasts have done incredibly well to have less than 2 marks taken off them, so to have only given cause for the judges to take away 1.2, that really is a very clean routine indeed.
Please show your
going back to our senior women now. We're going to be taking a look at the bars final. Now our top contender, Becky Downey, chose not to compete today, so we've definitely got a new champion here for 2015. And you can see there in third place, Claudia Fragapane. Managed to make that routine work better for her today. Got all of her connections in. Ellie Downey did really well in second place, a much better routine today. 14.15 her total has earned her the silver medal. But as you can see there, Taisha Mattis, first year senior from East London Gymnastics Club, is the senior British bars champion. 14.4 her total. Some really daring skills, tricks and connections in that routine. Taisha really is a trickster and we can't wait to have her back on all four pieces of apparatus. She can be a valuable asset to the British team when she's competing all around.
Ladies and gentlemen, your gymnasts. In addition to their awards, the gold medalists in today's final will by Milano Pro Sport, the official performance wear supplier to British gymnastics. Thank you, gymnastics. Next is the presentation for the Women's Disability Masters B. In third place, and winner of the bronze medal.
So turning our attention now back to our disability women, who also competed on the beam in that first section of the competition. In third place, with 5.85, Natasha Coates from The Wire. In second place, with a score of 6.7, from the City of Glasgow, Georgia Carslaw. But the champion here today in our disability competition on the beam, with a great score, 10.65, from the City of Glasgow, Sophie Crawford. Sophie is a truly remarkable gymnast and once again very deserving of this gold medal here today. Really hope that all of these gymnasts are soaking up the experience. Big congratulations to those gymnasts. I think that concludes the women's presentation so far. So we're going to kick off with our men's masters competition. And starting off with the floor. So our senior champion on the floor was Daniel Purvis. Only good enough for third place though today, 14.95 his total. In second place from the City of Birmingham, fantastic achievement for Dominic Cunningham, breaking the 15 barrier and deservedly winning that silver medal. However, our champion here today, Gianni Regini Moran, supremely confident here on the floor. Just looks so sure of all of his work on this apparatus. Solid on all of his landings, great form in the air. Had to move so quickly through the routine just to pack all of his difficulty in. But an incredibly deserving winner here. 15.45, that's a truly world-class score on the floor. I'm sure all of his teammates and coaches back in Europa are feeling very proud right now.
In addition to their awards, the gold medals in today's finals also received a training card kindly donated by Milano Pro Sport, the official performance wear supplier to British gymnastics.
So moving on now to the disability men on the box. In third place, 10.75 was the score for James Lang from Jersey. In second place, 11.15, Alexander Busnell earns the silver medal. But the champion, David Ray from the City of Glasgow Club, after that impressive vaulting, 11.45 his total. We of course saw that sky-high Tuk Sukahara vault from David. Showed really good, powerful, dynamic work here on this piece of apparatus, and nice to see him rewarded.
Next, we come to our presentation for the Men's British Masters Pommel Horse Competition.
the men's masters, this time focusing on Pommel Horse. And in third place, James Hall from Pegasus. But it really was a battle between the top two here on Pommel Horse. On this occasion, the silver medal going to Max Whitlock from South Essex. It's the only piece of apparatus we've seen him on here this weekend, so he'll be happy to be on the podium. But just pipping him at the post, a huge score, 15.975, just narrowly missing that huge 16 score. It's Lewis Smith. Looking absolutely delighted to be back on the top of this podium. He put in a great performance today. Managed to tidy up a little bit from yesterday. And of course, he'd already had Max going before him in the final, so he knew what he had to do. Lewis did really well to earn that gold medal today. Definitely a clean routine. His difficulty on the pommel horse was 6.9 with a 9.075 execution score. So just goes to show how clean it was. Max Whitlock, in fact, presented difficulty of 7.2. So it was 0.3 ahead with his start value. But just a little bit messier maybe. Just a couple of leg separations on some of his circling elements kept him down in silver. In the disabilities men's competition.
In second place, and winner of the silver medal, representing the city of Glasgow,
we're now focusing our attention on the pommel horse. In third place, with a score of 9.1 from Croydon School of Gymnastics, Philip Davis. In second, with 9.55 from the city of Glasgow, David Ray. And in first place, the disability champion on pommel horse, Alexander Boosnell from Jersey Special Gymnastics Club, 10.7 his total. All of these gymnasts had very similar difficulty on this piece of apparatus, but Alexander just going the extra mile, presenting a great clean routine and earning himself the gold medal here today.
Now the final presentation for the morning.
before the second session starts for our disability men.
And in first place, winner of the gold medal, representing Jersey Special Gymnastics Club, the 2015 Men's Disability Masters Ring Champion is Alexandra Musenal.
And there we go. This time, the presentation for the disability men on the rings. So to confirm the results, 10.4 earned Ramsey Micklem from the City of Glasgow a bronze medal. 11.3 the score for David Ray, also from the City of Glasgow, taking home the silver. But in gold medal position, our disability men's rings champion with 11.55 from Jersey Special Gymnastics, Alexander Busnell. Don't forget, we're only halfway through the action from today's competition. Still got plenty more gymnastics to come, so please do stay tuned.
That completes the victory ceremony for the first part of our Women's Apparatus Final Men's British Masters and Disability Masters competitions. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, would you please show your appreciation for our gymnasts as they lead the competition forward?
So we have now got an hour break until the next half of the competition starts. So go and get yourself a cup of tea, recover from the action so far, and we'll see you back in about an hour for the conclusion of the 2015 British Gymnastics Championship.
That completes the figure.